So just recently, you guys left in the comments that you wanted to see a video on how to create t-shirt designs using canva.com. So in this video, we're going to get into that step by step. Hi, everyone. I hope you're all having a great day so far. If you're new here, my name is Greg, and I like to talk about online entrepreneurship. So if you're interested in making money online or anything in that area, feel free to look through the channel and you might find some cool stuff that you like. If you are returning here, thank you guys so much for subscribing. You guys are absolutely awesome. And this goes to show that when you leave video requests down in the comments, I really want to make those videos for you. So if there are any specific videos that you want to see, feel free to leave them down in the comments. So in this video, we're going to get into how to create t-shirt designs using canva.com. Now, to give you a little bit of backstory, I always recommend using one of two smartphone apps. That's Typorama if you are on an iPhone and WordSwag if you are on an Android device. Now, where this gets a little bit hairy is Typorama is completely commercially usable. So you can make designs on there and then you can put them straight on t-shirts and you can profit from the sales of those t-shirts. Now, as far as WordSwag goes for Android users, it's partially commercially usable. Some of the fonts are commercially usable, some of them are not, but you can't tell which ones are which. So with that said, there's kind of a gray area until the app goes fully commercially usable. So it's almost use at your own risk for Android users. Now, that's not ideal. So that's why I recommend using canva.com. Canva.com is a completely free to use graphic design tool that you can use on a computer. This way you can do it whether you have a Mac or you have a PC, anyone can use this. But with that being said, it can be a little bit tricky. So in this video, I'm gonna go through everything from start to finish so you can start making t-shirt designs on Canva. All right, without further ado, let's hop in the computer and go to canva.com and that's where we'll start. All right, so this is canva.com. I've just logged into my account. You can just set up a free account and this is what it'll look like once you're logged in. So a couple things we need to note right off the bat here is typically people will go in and they will choose one of these preset templates to go off of. Now, creating t-shirt designs, we need it to be a big file size, so when it's printed on a t-shirt, which is actually a pretty big print, it's going to maintain its quality and not get blurry. So as you hover over some of these things, you can see it's 940 by 788 pixels, and these really aren't that big, 1,000 by 1,000. So what we need to do is we can either click right here, or what I like to do is just create a design, and then go to custom dimensions. And then here we'll go as big as they allow us to go, which is 5,000 pixels by 5,000 pixels. And we'll create a new design. Now we have a completely blank template that we can start with on Canva here that's 5,000 pixels by 5,000. So when we put this on a shirt, it'll be plenty big. So where I like to start is actually over on the text. So here you can find a bunch of different layouts and fonts that you can use for text on a shirt. So you can scroll through any of these and find one that you wanna go with, and I'll just go with one of the first ones here. Right here, this is a perfect example. So you just click this once, and as you can see how big our background is, this is perfect. Since this is text, we can make this as big as we want and it'll maintain its quality. So I'm going to drag this all the way out here until it basically fills the space. And then we can start to change this. So the first thing we need to do is, as you can see, all of these designs have multiple different types of font on them. So that's because they're grouped together and it's different types of fonts in one template. So the very first button we hit is ungroup. And then when we click off of it, anywhere off of the template here, we can see that when we hover over, it has the different elements separately. So we only need this main one here. So I'm just gonna click on this once and hit the delete button on my keyboard or the backspace, that'll do it too. And now this is what we're dealing with. This is going to be perfect. So now once you get your inspiration, there's other videos that I have on this channel on where to find ideas for shirts, but let's just say that we're going to make one around the yoga niche, which I typically use. I'm just gonna fill this in kind of ad lib as we go here. So I'm gonna fill this in yoga and then looks like a longer word right here. So let's go with sunshine. And this is just for example's sake. This might not even make sense when I put this together. Yoga, sunshine, and a shorter word here, wine. Yoga, sunshine, and wine. Okay, that might actually make a pretty cool shirt. I haven't done any research on this, but this is what I'm gonna use for this example. So then as you can see here, the sunshine actually went off of the template, so it will cut it off. So there's two things we can do if you run into this. You can triple click and it'll select everything here. Or you can just click and drag to select all of this, and then we can change it to, let's say, 900. And that'll make it fit right there. Now, the second thing that we can do, I'm just going to go back to where we just were. The second thing we can do is just drag in these corners here. So just drag that in a little bit, and it'll fit just like that. And what I like to do is put this towards the top of the design, so when we put it on a shirt, it is at chest level, and we shouldn't have to do much altering once we upload it to one of the print-on-demand sites that we're using, whether that's Teespring or Merch by Amazon, Redbubble, any of the others. So with that being said, just make sure that it's not too close to any of the sides where it's going to get cut off, and make sure that it's more towards the top than the bottom. And just one more thing before we move on, this is going to be left justified. So as you can see, the words are coming from the left and they're not centered. Typically I go with centered, but on some of these, it looks kind of cool just to put it left justified. So I'm gonna leave that as is. So this design is ready to go. So now all we have to do is download it. So we hit this little download button right here. And one of the things with Canva is I would love to be able to just hit this button right here and it would export it with a transparent background and we could go straight onto a t-shirt, but that is a premium feature. So if you try to turn this on, you have to do 30 days of a free trial and then you have to start paying for that. I really prefer not to add on extra bills, so I don't want to pay for this. So I'm going to show you the workaround after this. So with that being said, all we have to do now is just select PNG, make sure that's set. We can either go with PNG or JPEG. PNG is a little bit higher quality when we're exporting from Canva. So make sure we select PNG and then just download. And it only takes a second here and then it'll be downloaded right onto your computer. And as you can see, now we have this design right on our computer and it has a white background. So as I was just saying, there's one more step we need to do here, and that's to remove the background. Whenever you're uploading a design to print on demand or a t-shirt in general, you don't want to have a colored background unless that's part of the design that you're going with. It will show that background color when it's printed, and on the mockups that you get on these print on demand sites, it's not going to look right because you'll have a slightly different color white on a white shirt. And long story short is just make sure you take the background out before you upload it to any of these sites. So if you are using a Mac, you are definitely in luck. I use a Mac, it's an Apple computer. So with that being said, all we have to do is really one step here. So I'm just gonna make this a little smaller. All we have to do is hit this little pencil icon right here, which is the edit. And then we come to the instant alpha tool right here. And all we have to do is click that, turn that on. And then anywhere that it's white in the background, all you have to do is click and drag. And it'll select everything that is connected and that color. So as you can see, the white inside of the dots is not connected, so we'll have to do that next. But it selects everything that is white and connected. So all you do is just drag it and then let go, and all of that will be selected. Now, something I do want to show you is that if I click off of this and do that again, the further you drag, the more detailed it gets. So as you can see, if you go too far, it'll select all of the black as well. So we want to go just until it's just behind the black. So that means we are as close to the text as we possibly can be while deleting all the white. So since that's all selected now, all we have to do is hit the delete or backspace button and it deletes the whole background right there. Now just make sure you don't miss all of the little white dots that are inside of the shapes. So we'll click those, drag them and delete. And now we have a design that's our text with no background. So this is ready to go onto Teespring. This is ready to go onto Redbubble. Now, if you were to upload this onto Merch by Amazon, you have to do one more step. Now, if you are familiar with Merch by Amazon, it's another huge print on demand, but the only different requirement is they have a specific pixel ratio for the designs that you upload, which is 4,500 pixels by 5,400 pixels. When we made this design, it was 5,000 pixels by 5,000 pixels. Now, there's two things we can do here. When we make all of our designs in the future, we could make them 4,500 pixels by 5,400 pixels right off the bat, and that would solve the problem. Now, if you are designing on Typorama, or if you did 5,000 by 5,000 here, there's just one other step you have to take here, and it's very simple. It's this website right here called bulkresizephotos.com, and extremely simple to use and completely free. All you have to do is choose the image right here. And then once we've selected that image, just change a couple things. So change 50 to 100, and then we'll go to exact dimensions, 4,500 by 5,400, and then switch it to expert mode, which is completely free to do. And we'll just switch it to a PNG, which will have a transparent background. Make sure that the padding is turned on. You want that to be checked. That's so it's not going to stretch or squash your image. It won't distort your text. And then all you do is start resizing. It only takes literally a second here. And now save to our computer, we have both the first one that we made and we have the second one that is now formatted for Merch by Amazon. So what's kind of cool about that is Teespring and Redbubble and all the other print on demand websites, they don't have a specific size that you have to upload. So technically you can design them all in 4,500 by 5,400 and be able to upload them to every print on demand website. So now when you're uploading your design to these websites, they are plenty big, so you can zoom in, and when they're printed, you won't lose any clarity because they're huge designs. So just make sure that when you're uploading on Merch by Amazon, you're selecting the second version of it that we just made on this bulk resize photos, so it's formatted properly. So the last thing kind of goes without saying, and that's that if you're on a Mac, it's going to be extremely easy to take the background out. But if you are on a PC, it's going to be a little bit more difficult. Either you're going to need Photoshop or go to Google and find a website that'll allow you to do it on their website. I know Pixlr Editor will allow you to do it, and you can do that on any computer. Online Photo Scissors will allow you to do it, but at the end, you can only export in low quality, so it's iffy if you're going to upload that to a shirt. If you want to export in their high quality, you have to pay. So with that being said, if you are on a PC, there's a million different ways to do this, but you may have to do a little bit extra homework to find out how to remove the background. Or the other thing is you can just use the free 30-day trial on Canva and get as many designs through there with the transparent background as you can, and just try to stockpile them within your 30 days before you would have to pay. So I hope this video has helped you guys. If you have any questions about how to make t-shirt designs on Canva, leave them down in the comments and I'll get an answer back to you. And also, if you have any specific video topics that you want to see, leave them in the comments as well and I'll add them to the video list and make them for you. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this one and I'll see you in the next one.